Major breaking news unfolding right now. A story Western News broke at 10 o'clock.
A breach in patient information at Florida Hospital, once thought to involve 2,000 patients, now reportedly involves as many as 700,000. Good evening. I'm Martha Sigalski.
I'm Jim Payne. One man has been indicted. Others could follow. Investigators say they sold that patient information, and they did it on a massive scale. West 2's Bob Keeling uncovered this information tonight and joins us live with more. Bob?
Yeah, Jim, and this five-count indictment was just unsealed in the last 36 hours, and it details how a fired Florida Hospital Celebration ER worker would actually register patients and then, over a two-year period, allegedly access the information of a vast number of patients to try to find car accident victims, then allegedly sold it to a middleman who peddled it to unnamed lawyers and chiropractors. According to an indictment unsealed Wednesday, a former Florida hospital clerical worker named Dale Monroe II is now charged federally with accessing the information of as much as 700,000 patients over a two-year period. Federal investigators say Monroe was looking for specific information on car accident victims and then selling that information to unspecified co-conspirators. This is far more than the 2,000 patients Florida Hospital announced originally that may have been affected. The case started in Celebration with the Osceola County Sheriff's Office and was picked up by the FBI.
But because there are so many hospitals in Central Florida and the number of possible victims out there, that is the reason why the FBI was brought into this.
Originally, Monroe, his wife, and another woman were terminated after hospital investigators noted what they called an extreme amount of patient information that may have been accessed. Only now do we have a better idea of the extent of it. Now, this indictment alleges that Monroe pocketed at least $1,000 for this illegal access of information. No word yet on whether the two people who were fired originally with him, including his wife, may be indicted. So far, we have not been able to get an immediate comment from Florida Hospital. We're still working to do that. Live in Osceola County, I'm Bob Keeling, West 2 News.